From gold and copper to iron ore and silver, natural minerals are the fuel that powers the global economy. These valuable minerals are found underneath the Earth's crust and in rocks that lie on the seabed. However, they're also deposited in huge quantities in several mysterious interstellar objects, including the asteroid that's worth more than global economy. Join us in today's video as we explore these space-hovering money rocks that can make you a billionaire overnight. Asteroids are small, odd-shaped rocks that orbit the Sun. They're sometimes called minor planets because they're too small to be called planets. And of course, they're way too big to be called meteoroids. For perspective, Ceres, the world's biggest asteroid, is nearly as big as Alaska. In contrast, the 2015 TC2, the smallest asteroid discovered, is only as big as two baseball bats, or six bottles of wine. At the last count, there are over 1 million asteroids that we know of. Most of them are located in between Mars and Jupiter, along the main asteroid belt. According to scientists, most asteroids are made of gold, platinum, and other rare metals that are in high demand here on Earth. According to NASA, the entire constellation of asteroids along the main belt is worth around $700 quintillion. If someone were able to convert all that into real money, everyone on Earth could receive over $90 billion. But in reality, we probably don't need to harvest all the asteroids in the solar system to enjoy a good life that we've always wanted. This right here is the Bennu asteroid. It's worth a whopping $669 million. Here is Ryugu, estimated to be worth around $82 billion. And then Davida, which holds the record for being the world's most expensive minor planet, which is valued at $27 quintillion. But for now, scientists are more interested in exploring 16 Psyche, a 10,000 quadrillion dollar asteroid that dwarfs the value of the world's economy. In fact, its value reaches 70,000 times that of the global economy. Named after Psyche, an ancient Greek goddess of the soul, this asteroid was discovered by Italian astronomer Annabel de Gasperis on March 17, 1853. According to experts, the composition of this potato-shaped object is similar to Earth. 16 Psyche measures 140 miles in diameter, and unlike some other asteroids that are made up of rock or ice, it is quite dense and made up of precious metals. We've seen meteorites that are mostly metal, but Psyche could be unique in that it might be an asteroid that is totally made of iron and nickel, a planetary scientist at the Southwest Research Institute in San Antonio, Dr. Tracy Becker, said in a statement. Often regarded as the holy grail of asteroids, this special interstellar element has caught the eye of NASA and other private entities who are now actively trying to mine it. According to astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson, asteroid mining in space could produce the first set of trillionaires on Earth. The first trillionaires will be those who mine asteroids, he said lately. Could he be right? Nobody knows just yet, at least until a piece of asteroid is mined. But come to think of it, how will asteroid mining work? Here on Earth, mining natural resources is a tough job. It involves trillions of dollars, several sophisticated machines, and hundreds of work hours. Well, imagine doing all that in space. Undoubtedly, it would be extremely difficult and much more expensive, but certainly not impossible. Before that, however, we'll need to get to the main asteroid belt, which is located between Mars and Jupiter. But it's not going to be a short ride, as on average, the closest edge of the belt lies around 210 million miles from us, or 1.5 times the distance between Earth and the Sun. While Elon Musk is trying to colonize Mars, NASA has its sights set on the goodies of 16 Psyche asteroid. In fact, the agency has a dedicated program to pursue this agenda. It's called the NASA Psyche mission, and it's starting later this year in August. An unmanned SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket will take off from the Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida with NASA's probe machine for this program. From then on, it is expected to travel through the emptiness of space for a little over 3 years until it gets to the main asteroid belt in January 2026. Upon arrival, the spacecraft will orbit 16 Psyche for the next 21 months, taking close-up photographs and studying the asteroid's characteristics to ascertain if it is truly worth what we think it is. On condition that great news comes in, the next step would be to mine it and get as much precious metal as we can get. But nobody has ever mined an asteroid in space before. Luckily, some of the greatest minds on Earth have already done their theoretical experiments and calculations. According to them, these are the three possible ways asteroids could be mined in the future. The number one option would be to bring the asteroids down to Earth before mining them. That would save us the cost of having to build a mining infrastructure in space. For sure, such a landing is unimaginable today, but in the near future, it could be everyday routine. Until then, scientists have to solve how and where we are going to land them, and every little detail of their processing, including the law that regulates the whole process. Another option would be to mine the asteroids in space. This would require specialized spaceships and newly designed mining equipment. Building and operating them, however, is no easy game. At this very moment, humanity is far from the technological development needed for such an act. Lastly, scientists can decide to drag the asteroids closer to a suitable orbit around the Earth or Moon using magnetic tugged flying robots. Non-metallic asteroids can be pulled with special wires before they're mined. But whether we choose to mine them in space or bring them down here on Earth, one thing is certain. Mining asteroids is no cheap business. According to estimates, a typical asteroid mining mission would cost around $2.6 billion. That initial investment cost is very much negligible, especially when you consider the rewards. But as mentioned earlier, the process is not straightforward and does have its setbacks. The Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency has twice brought back samples of asteroids to Earth. The first was the Hayabusa mission, which cost $250 million, but in the end, the sample that the spacecraft returned were mere dust particles. Also, experts have warned the world that bringing gold-laden asteroids to Earth could completely wreck the global economy. Without a doubt, many would have loved NASA to bring down the asteroid, sell it off and share it equally among the world's population. That sounds like a great plan, but unfortunately we have to burst this bubble, as that's never going to happen. Economists have warned everybody that bringing large amounts of precious metals to Earth will make it lose its value. For instance, if we would to bring down 5% of 16 Psyche to Earth, gold would have the same value as paper. You can imagine what would happen if we were able to mine all of its treasures, but maybe there is a solution for its best use. What if we mine and use the minerals from these asteroids in space? That would make a lot of sense, actually. It's no secret that Elon Musk is trying to colonize. That mission needs a lot of supplies from Earth, including some of the minerals contained inside 16 Psyche to make it happen. And, coincidentally, this asteroid is just next door to Mars. Eventually, we could have a situation in the near future where NASA would mine 16 Psyche in space and then move the extracted minerals to Mars to support Musk's colonization efforts.